All right, here we go. We start off this year's 39th parade, as always, with the Wampum Police Chief, Frank Ginetti. Following Frank is the Newcastle Honor Guard. Castle Honor Guard. Thank you, gentlemen. Following the Honor Guard. We have Gary Hassan coming up the street as our yearly bagpiper. Gary's been a part of the parade for several years now. Leading our Christmas banner, carried by the Indian Chiefs. This year our Indian Chiefs are RJ Magno and Harmony Casper. Coming up next is this year's Grand Marshal. Our Grand Marshal this year is Bob Marshall. What a coincidence. Bob is a lifelong resident of Wampum Borough. He's the fourth generation owner of the Marshall Funeral Homes, which is a 106-year-old business. Bob's been married for 36 years. He's a member of the Wampum Area Business Association since its inception. He's also been a member of the Wampum Lions Club for 30 years. And he's a member of the Wampum United Presbyterian Church. We thank Bob for being our Grand Marshal. Then we have a couple of Indian Braves with the Wampum banner. Peyton Caminetti and Dylan Lloyd. Next, we have something very special. This year's parade is dedicated to Gene Cody and also honoring Lou Ferranti. The loss of these two lifelong residents of Wampum has touched many people. Both of these men worked hard for many years to make Wampum a better place to live in. Gene served on town council for many years and was a key member of the Christmas Parade Committee and served in the capacity that I now hold for 16 years. Lou was a businessman, loved Wampum, and promoted the town every chance that he could. The Wampum Area Business Association presented a plaque in honor of Lou, and it is going to be located at the town gazebo. Both of these outstanding citizens and family men are and will be missed greatly. Next, we have the Honor Guard from the National Guard 107th of Newcastle. Again, we're going to do something a little different this year. 2011 being the 10th anniversary of the terror attack and destruction of the Twin Towers in New York has prompted the parade committee to include the honoring of the heroes of our country in this year's parade. The sacrifice and service the men and women of our military is at the top of the list. We cannot forget our local heroes either. The police, the firefighters who risk their lives, the first responders who answer the emergency calls belong on this list also. While we can't acknowledge all of the heroes in our lives, we can mention a few more. How about the crossing guards who protect our children at the busy intersection? The doctors and nurses who save lives every day? The teacher who challenges you to do your best to try to become someone great? The sports figure that inspires you to give your all to the team? The clergyman who teaches compassion and forgiveness in path of hate and prejudice? The person who looks in on a sick neighbor, or a kind person who may pick up a package that you dropped? These are just a few of the heroes that surround us every day. If you come across a hero, take a moment to thank them for their sacrifice, their inspiration, their kindness, and their support. Thanks to all our heroes. We have the Wampum American Legion Post 79, 4749, honoring veterans from World War II, Korea, Vietnam, Iraq. We also have police, firemen, first responders. Coming up next, State Trooper Ronald Kestner from our Pennsylvania State Police. Well, next we have Lady Liberty. Our own Statue of Liberty, Hannah Haswell. And then Hills Mills. Oh no, we have some other veterans here. Huh? FW Post 8106 of New Galley. That float is entitled American Pride. Next, Hills Mills. Here's Miles in his patriotic truck. And here come the county's youngest volunteers. The American Red Cross disaster truck. All part of heroes in our world. Thank you, American Red Cross, for participating today. Well, as you can hear now, the sirens of the fire trucks, things are going to get a little loud for the next few minutes. The fire trucks will bring up the rear of our salute to heroes. Most or all of these units are all volunteers. And I'm sure they're always looking for new members. Anyone that wants to become a fireman, please see your local fire department. Yeah, coming in. And of course they lead off with our own Wampum Borough Fire Department.
Get it?
Next, we have Wayne Township Volunteer Fire Department. These men and women that serve in these departments are always on call 24 hours a day. Take time out from their personal lives, their work lives, to try to save and protect our residences, our lives. Sacrifice time away from their families in training. Very often taken for granted. Chenango Township Volunteer Fire Department, followed by some new Beaver Volunteer Fire Department. They have their mule here today, all decked out. Thank you, gentlemen. Come on, folks, give these fire departments a hand. They're out there to help you. Typically in the past, all of the fire trucks were your typical red, but as of the last several years, now we're getting into more designer colors on the fire trucks, like this wonderful blue truck coming. Part of New Galilee Volunteer Fire Department. Thank you for coming.
You guys get more candy down there.
Many of these departments hold raffles and bake sales and sell sandwiches and all kinds of craft shows, trying to raise money to buy new equipment. The cost of these vehicles is just astronomical. It takes many, many years to raise enough money to replace one of these vehicles. Our friends from Chuton Volunteer Fire Department, Thank you for coming today. All of these volunteers take time to train so that they know how to work the equipment properly, efficiently, deal with the situations that arise during the crisis of a fire, of an auto wreck, most any emergencies they deal with nowadays. So they reach far beyond just fires. Shooting Volunteer Fire Department. Our good friends from across the river. North Beaver Township Volunteer Fire Department. Thank you, North Beaver. Elwood City Fire Department Fire Rescue. Thank you for coming today. Next, we have a vehicle from the Lawrence County Department of Public Safety. A flyover by the medevac helicopter coming in from the north. Scott Township Volunteer Fire Department. There he comes, right here. Medevac. Thank you, medevac. Franklin Township Volunteer Fire Department. I don't think we've ever had this many fire departments show up for our parade. We thank you for your coming down, participating in our tribute to our heroes. And coming up, Frisco Volunteer Fire Department. And once again, there goes the medevac helicopter over. Frisco Volunteer Fire Department will finish up our tribute to our local heroes, all of our heroes. Remember, watch for your heroes and thank them. Thank you for coming down. Normally, the fire departments signal the end of our parade. But this year we have much more in store. Still a lot of parade left. Here comes our Christmas Nutcrackers next. This year the Nutcrackers are Bailey Brandt and Alexis Gallagher. The parade committee is always in need of children of all ages, young adults, to participate in our parade, whether in a costume or driving a car or participating in a float. So if you have any children that would be interested in being in our parade, please contact someone from the Christmas Parade Committee, and I'm sure we can find a place for anyone. Next is our Wampum Mayor, Jeff Steffler. He's being driven today by Jackie Fisher. Jeff is a hardworking fellow who participates in the workings of the parade in the background, does a lot for the parade, helps us out a lot to get this thing on and make it go smooth. Wampum Council President Carol Lee Lawhead, being driven by her husband, who's always the driver, right, John? Always the driver. John, you're going too fast. John, turn left. John. There's some M&Ms next. Zach Marshall, Ryan Ayers, and Cody Kirkwood. And next we have our state senator, Elder Vogel.
And
Elwood City Councilwoman.
Yeah, right here.
How'd you get snuck in there?
I don't know. Merry Christmas.
We certainly don't want to leave out Elwood City Council. Couple more of our popular characters. Next, Mickey and Minnie Mouse. This year, that's Josh Kurtz and Taylor Kirkwood. Our county commissioners. In that 88 Old Delta from McElwain's, Dan Vogler. Dan grew up here in Wampum. And of course, Steve Craig.
Cody, how are you?
Fine, Dan, Michelle. Thank you guys for coming down. Always a pleasure to have you here. Gives you a chance to come back home to Wampum, Dan. Our next float has been put in the parade by the Apolito family. It's entitled The Grinch in Whoville. And they've won third place in our general category. A lot of hard work goes into these floats, folks. It's showing you appreciate it now. And the Grinch brings up the rear, of course.
Go,
with all the little who's. Another regular addition to our parade is Thomas the Tank. Very popular with the children. Today we have Trevor Harris and Trent Bonfield helping Thomas the Long. From our good neighbors, New Beaver, the New Beaver Council President, David Hairhogger. Dave Badger, they slipped one in on me. So I don't always get all the changes, but that's all right, we'll work with it. Next we have our state representative, Jarrett Gibbons. Jarrett's participated in the last couple parades now. We always like our politicians to come down. Our next float coming down the street is from Studio P, School of Performing Arts. This float is entitled Misfit Toys. The Misfit Toys. There's the Bumble out in the beginning here, right out in the front, the Bumble. Studio P, School of Performing Arts, the Misfit Toys. And the Shenango High School, Chapter of SAD, Students Against Drunk Driving.
Thank you. from here.
Our next float is from the Disney movie Cars. On our Cars float today, we have Andy, Blake, and Caleb Lloyd. That must be Andy over in the orange. Oh, that's Andy. Okay. Next is the 4-H Paw Prints Club, under the direction of Joan Badger. All these young people work with dogs. They have dogs that they train. They all get together. It's a great little organization. I'm sure they'd be interested in any members that would like to join, learn how to train their dogs. And of course, all the kids love the dogs. Our next entry in today's parade is from the Chutin Christian Church. This float is entitled A Gift from God and won second place in our religious category. Thank you, folks, for your hard work and your participation.
You're welcome. Merry Christmas.
Same to you. And we have a couple of smileys next. We always have smileys in the parade. This year, our smileys are Libby Main and Katie Kingman. Dogs are still checking out the kids here. Libby and Katie are passing out candy to the kids. Following our smileys, we have the Red Hat Queen, Louise Carroll. The Red Hat Queen has been a part of our parade for the last few years now. And Louise is being driven by her son, Michael Carroll, who lives right here in Wampum. The Red Hat Society was founded in 1988. It's the largest women's social group in the world. Approximately 50,000 registered members. There are 24,000 chapters worldwide. Oh, Next, we have some music coming up by the Wine and Spirit musical group. So we'll let them do their thing here for a minute.
Go riding in a wampum sleigh. Jingle, jingle, world's bigger than me. Jingle up around the wide. And it turns to you in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell round.
Make the wine and spirit. We have the Cat in the Hat sneaking in behind him. That's Samantha Iris. And then the Elwood City Scout Troop 806, Scoutmaster Doug Smith. Our next little float is from the Gateway Commerce, Gateway to Christmas. Christmas. Definitely looks like Christmas Story to me. I want that lamp. Donald and Daisy Duck are next. Melissa and Beth Ann McDonald. Next are some peppermints and Candy Kiss. The peppermints are Leah McClintock and Amber Mora, and the Candy Kiss is Mallory Norge. Next is the Lawrence County Bicycle Club.
Thank you.
Orange County Bicycle Club.
How'd everything go?
Our next entry is the Lawrence County Outstanding Distinguished Young Woman, Hunter Hill. And from the movie Toy Story, we have Woody and Jesse, which are Lexi Hickman and Crystal Benson, and a couple of Christmas presents, Katie Fitzgerald and Grace Blake. Our next float entry is the Lawrence County Dairy Princess, Cassie Musser.
Thank you.
Give these floats a hand, folks. There's a lot of time and work goes into these.
Thank you.
Don't forget the Wampum Area Women's Club Bazaar being held at the Legion, the American Legion, at the corner of Beaver and Orchard Street. Stop by after the parade. They have food, beverages, a bake sale, and raffles. Our next unit is the K9 SOS and PAWSAR of Lawrence County.
The Aftermath Man.
A nonprofit organization whose main objective is to assist emergency agencies in search and rescue. This is a service that they provide free of charge. To provide aid in emergency situations. And of course, once again, all the kids love the dogs. A lot of the adults do. And these dogs are very well trained, well behaved. Owners spend a lot of time training and working with these animals and making them available to the different fire departments, rescue associations when they're needed. Next float entry is from Mohawk Scout Troop 1004, Mohawk Area Girl Scouts. Scout leader Sandy Barnes. This float is entitled, They Will Be Home for Christmas. Mohawk Area Girl Scouts, Troop 1004. They will be home for Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, everyone!
Next are the Mohawk Pee Wee Cheerleaders. Maybe we can get a cheer out of them if we're lucky. Excellent. That's excellent. Thank you. Mohawk Homecoming Queen and King. Maren Nottingham and John Fleck. Mohawk mini majorettes. And as you can hear, the Mohawk Junior Senior High School Band, under the direction of Ashley Graziani. The band is the Mohawk Mini Majorettes, under the leadership and direction of Barb Maravola. Our next float is a first-time entry in our parade from the Wampum Hardware Company. The Wampum Hardware Company is a general hardware and explosive store located in Wampum. It was purchased in 1904 by two Davis brothers. This rural store was quick to become a household name as well as a dependable resource for necessities like building materials, barbed wire, and dynamite. In the 1960s, under the fourth generation leadership of Jerry and Paul Davis, Wampum decided to go beyond selling farm goods and cases of explosives. What started out as a small hardware store run by two brothers is now a highly regarded force in the explosives industry. It is now one of the largest blasting companies in North America in terms of shot service. With over 200 employees, Wampum crews are known for being a hardworking, safety-oriented bunch, always capable of overcoming the most demanding blasting challenges. Wampum hardware employees and the Davis family want you to have a Merry Christmas and a blast during the holidays. Thank you. Thank you, Wampum Hardware. Following up Wampum Hardware is another new entry in our parade this year from the H.J. Heinz Company. It's Squeeze the Ketchup. Inside of Squeeze is Chad Blance of Wampum. And he's being followed by two clowns, Lori Blance, Brenda Mayer, and of course, Harley Mayer in the wagon. And they're handing out some ketchup sample packets, some dip and squeeze packets, courtesy of H.J. Heinz. Following them from the Newcastle News is Reed Daly and Spot the Dog. The Newcastle News has participated in our parade many times. And of course, always covering the local news and happenings in the area.
Where's Santa?
Our next float is entitled True Blue. True Blue, the Smurfs. Our Smurfs today are Josie Van Kirk, Alexis Lambert, and Ariana Conti. I think that's them underneath all that paint. The Smurfs. And a couple of popular characters from Sesame Street, Bert and Ernie. Today, Bert and Ernie are Billy Evans and Matt Fleck. Next, we have Dance Explosion. Okay. Dance Expressions, too. Under the direction of Pam McDonald. Following the Dance Expression is our next float entry from the First Alliance Christian Church. This float is entitled, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas, and All the Creatures Are Looking for Jesus, Are You?" This float won first place this year in our religious category. First Alliance Christian Church, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas, and All the Creatures Are Looking for Jesus, Are You?" And also including some veterans. Thank you for your service. Our little Christmas angels. Our angels this year, Noel Parker, Amber Fitzgerald, Delaney Blake, and Mary Thomas. Next we have a Christmas angel. Perched atop a 2009 Corvette, driven by David Sobsack. This is "Jesus is the Light of the World," lit up by Sobsack Electric. Third place in the religious category. And of course, from Elwood City, the Lincoln High School Blue Band, under the direction of Lee Caldwell, the Junior Senior Dance Line, under the direction of Betty Bainey DeLoya. This band was chosen by WPXI as the 2010 Band of the Year. Thank you. Next we have the Mattis race car from Mattis Service Station. Mattis Service Center and the race car. Another expensive endeavor. You can see the sponsors' names on the car. Next, we have a group of superheroes. Cartoon and comic book heroes are important in our lives, too. They're an inspiration to kids also, so we can't forget them. We have more than I have names for. We have Rachel Shear as Batgirl. Jason Myers is Captain America. Shawn Myers is Superman. I don't know who Thor is. Or Spider-Man. I don't have them on my list, so we'll have to. They must be the real thing. That's the real Spider-Man and the real Thor.
Heads up. Heads up.
Mohawk Scout Troop 16109. Scout leader Heidi Pyatt. This next group has been a part of our parade for the last few years now. The Furries. The Furries are a group of local costumers, part of the anthropomorphic fandom, who don animal mascot costumes to bring smiles to young and old, and raise money annually for charities dedicated to the welfare of animals, wild and domestic. I'm sure the Furries will be up at the gymnasium after the parade. While the treats are being handed out so kids can get pictures with the Furries. Medevac. Candyland salutes American heroes. This float was second place in our general category. Followed up by Medevac and Noga. Again, a big part of our hero theme this year. Elwood City Group, Girl Scouts, Troop 10528. This is entitled Winter Wonderland.
Yeah.
bike riders. Those young children are riding bikes in memory of their grandfather, John Yanko Miller. The next entry is from the City Rescue Mission. This float is entitled The Gingerbread House. Constructed under the supervision of Jan O'Brien, this float won first prize in our general category. You'll notice that the gingerbread house has a for sale sign on it. The gingerbread house is for sale. The proceeds from the sale of that gingerbread house will be donated to the City Rescue Mission. Would look real good in somebody's backyard. Probably up on Upper Main Street. He's not paying attention to me. The gingerbread house is for sale. You can be the proud owner of that. Another favorite character in our parade, Elmo from Sesame Street. Elmo. And in portraying Elmo is Sherry North. Next entry coming down the street has been a favorite of this parade for the last several years. Traveling here from Franklin, PA was the Vision Quest drill team. The Vision Quest drill team is under the direction and leadership of Colonel Moss.
Thank you.
once again. The Vision Quest drill team from Franklin, PA, under the direction of Colonel Moss. Thank you, Colonel Moss and Vision Quest. All right, now signaling the end of our parade coming up here. Season's greetings from Mrs. Claus. Mrs. Claus and the elves. The elves with Mrs. Claus are Gavin Harris, Aiden Davis, Madison Herventine, Sean and Seth Christopher. Mrs. Claus made that long trip today from the North Pole just to be here for the kids. And of course, you know who brought her? Old Father Christmas himself, Santa Claus. Ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Presented by the Wampum Area Lions Club. The elves today with Santa are Lena and Ava Nolf, Jonathan Ferrani and Madison Chmielewski. And it looks like following up Santa are the 4-H
Running Rebels.
You can't hardly have a parade without horses. And the 4-H Trailblazers. Thank you all for coming out for our 39th parade. We hope you enjoyed it. We look forward to seeing you next year. You can follow the horses and the kids. And of course, Santa to the gymnasium to pick up your treats, to tell Santa what you'd like for Christmas. And if you would, tell them I've been really good. Thank you again for all coming out. Have a great rest of today.
Thank you.